Hello, I'm Mayanna with Block 8, and in this tutorial, I'll show you how to acquire and set up an Amazon S3 account to store your WordPress site backup files and media files, such as audio, video, and PDFs. So let's get started. Let's clear up a little jargon. Amazon Web Services, or AWS, offers a dizzying array of storage options. Amazon Simple Storage Solution, AS3, is just one of them, and the one we'll be covering in this tutorial. To set up an account, you'll need to enter the following info, so be sure to have them handy before you start. And you can use your business info if you like. You'll need your name, address, phone number, where you can answer a call during the verification process, credit card info, a unique name for the file folder bucket that you're going to use, and that bucket will need to be all lowercase, but you can have a period or a dot between words. So if it's for your backups, consider using something like a shortened version of backup.sitename or sitename.backup. Okay, let's get started. First, go to the link for Amazon S3, and then click the Get Started with Amazon S3 button. Now, if you have a personal account with Amazon.com, you can use it, but I would strongly encourage you to create a new account just for your business. If you want to use your personal account, select the I am a returning user radio button and input your login credentials. If you want to create a new business account, click the I am a new user radio button, and this is the path we'll be taking in this video. Input the email address you would like to use for your account, and then leave the password field blank. And then click the Sign In using our Secure Server button. You'll be taken to a form to create the credentials for your new account. Fill in everything and write all of that down for safekeeping. Then click the Create Account button. You'll be taken to a form to create the contact information for your new account. Fill in everything and write all of that down for safekeeping. Now remember for the phone number part to put a phone number in where you can receive a call to verify your account, and then input the security check, check the box for AWS customer agreement, and then click the Create Account and Continue button. On the next screen, enter your payment information. You will need to input a credit card number. The next screen is to verify your identity. Provide a telephone number where you can be called and enter the PIN number that they're going to show you on the next screen. Now, I've done this a couple of times, and I've had very different experiences. One time, it had a person's voice on the other end that I had to wait for her to finish to say input my PIN number, and then another time I called, it didn't say anything. And I input it, and it didn't do anything. When I hung up the call, it said that the verification process was complete. So, don't get frustrated if this doesn't work exactly like you think it ought to. When you're finished, click the Continue to select your support plan. Let's scroll down so we can see these. And honestly, the basic one is fine to start with. So scroll down and click the Continue button. Now you'll be taken to a welcome screen and you'll receive an email with your account info too. It may take anywhere from a few minutes to a few hours for your account to become active. Now once it does, click the Complete Sign Up button at the top or Launch Management Console button, whichever it says for you. And this time, input your email and click the radio button for I am a returning user and input your password, then click the Sign In using our Secure Server button. This is your AWS Services dashboard. You have two sections to it. One is Recently Visited Services and the other is All Services. If S3 is not listed in the Recently Visited, you can find it under Storage. Okay, let's jump in and create our bucket. Amazon S3 file folders are called buckets. Now, like Twitter handles, bucket names are global, so you can't use one that someone else might have already taken. And they need to be all lowercase in a single word. No capitals, spaces, hyphens, or underscores. Scroll down and click the Get Started button. Enter a DNS compliant bucket name. Now remember, it has to be all lowercase, no spaces, hyphens, or underscores, but you can use a dot or a period between words, like a domain name. In fact, That's what DNS compliance is, a domain type name. Now, it also has to be unique, so you may have to come up with a few variations to find one that hasn't already been taken. I'm going to use a variation of the word backup, dot, and the name of my site. Amazon will choose a region based on your IP address. Make note of it. And if you already have another bucket, you can copy its settings. But since this is your first one, I'm going to make the screen smaller so we can see. Scroll down and click Next. Now, I've been through this a couple of times, and it varies in what you see on your next screen. You may see this to set up your properties, or you may go straight to permissions. We're going to leave everything like this is and hit Next. Now you can set up your permissions. And these are going to vary depending on what type of files you're storing in this bucket. If they're backup files, you can leave all of the permission settings just like they are. Let's have a look at the public permissions. As you can see, everything is unchecked. But if these are media files that the public needs to access, like an audio or video file, then you may have to set permissions. For videos, you likely won't have to set any permissions here, but that may depend on the video player or controller that you're using, like S3 Media Maestro or S3 Flow Shield to help hide the part of the path to the bucket. For audio files, you may need to allow the public to read in the object permissions. Check with your audio player to confirm. You can always return to your bucket permissions settings to change them later. For now, click the Next button. This is the final review of your bucket settings. Click the Create Bucket button. You can have subfolders in your buckets too. This is handy if you have multiple types of folders per site and you want all of those files in one bucket, but each in their own subfolder. However, setting up a bucket for each site and each file type is preferred for better security. For example, setting up a unique bucket for just backups on each site is a good idea. Then, if you have other media files you want to share, set up a bucket for that site and then subfolders for each media type. Just keep your backups separated for better security. Okay, click the bucket to open it. And I'll show you how to create a folder. Click the Create Folder button. The folder name will also need to be DNS compliant. So we're going to call it Videos. And just leave it at that. If you want to put the site name in, you can do that too. And then click Save button. If you just click the folder name to open it, you can manually upload your files. Now, there's one last thing I want to show you before we get into accessing security keys that you'll need for your plugins. Log out of your account. The next time you want to access it, you can use one of these two links. Once you're there, click the Sign into Console button. Or you can go to My Account and click AWS Management Console. And then just input your email address and your password and click the Sign In Using Our Secure Server button. Now once you sign in, you'll land on the AWS Services page. It's a lot easier to get to where you're going from the recently visited services, so click S3 again. And you'll be taken to your list of buckets. And you can work with these just like you do regular folder listings. At this point, you'll need your AWS security credentials to connect your plugin to your AS3 account and the correct bucket. You can find them in the top right by clicking the down arrow next to your name and then My Security Credentials. This pops up a warning that you're about to access your security credentials for the whole account and to consider creating an IAM user instead. Now, if you want to create a new set of keys, click Continue, and then click Access Keys. Now here it gives you another warning that there's been a change to the AWS setup, and you can't access your master keys, but you can create new access keys. Click that, and it says that they've been created, and click the Show Access Key link to see them. I would also suggest that you download the key file. Once you're finished here, click Close. Now, I would strongly encourage you to consider creating a new IAM user instead of using these master keys. You never want to put master keys like this into plugins. Instead, you seriously want to consider creating a new user with its own set of security credentials and then restricting access for that user to only one bucket. That way, if a hacker ever gets into your site and steals your AS3 keys, they will only be able to access that one bucket, not your entire AS3 account. Plus, you can go a step further and set up version control so that a hacker can't overwrite or destroy previous backup files. And you can even create a rule to have your backup files auto-delete after a certain period of time, saving you on storage fees. Setting up the IAM user and all the permissions is a bit technical, and you can use the master keys for now and then contact a webmaster, including me at blogaid.net, to help you set up the rest. Now, if you're a webmaster, designer, or maintain sites for clients and want to learn how to fully secure an AS3 account, see Level 2 of my webmaster training courses that has several tutorials on Amazon S3, as well as backing up and migrating sites with several popular plugins and services.